On court number two, men's doubles, please welcome from Korea, Lee Yong-dae and Yoo Yoon-soo. And they're facing from Denmark, Anders Skov Rasmussen and Kim Astrup Sørensen.
Hello and a very warm welcome to the ancient city of Oldenzaar on the island of Fyn for the Yonex Denmark Open, event number 9 on the 12 tournament MetLife BWF World Super Series. Not only is this the 9th event, but we return to Super Series action after a 3-month sabbatical. And the Denmark Open is, of course, one of the 5 premier events, an even higher tier of tournament within the Super Series. So we're obviously going to have a long pause before any of the graphics come up, or is that... Okay. Okay, so if after that's what I've just said, the Denmark Open, one of the 5 premier events, an even higher tier of tournament within the Super Series. Well, 5 matches for you this afternoon, and we're going to be starting with a women's singles. And the World Championship bronze medalist Mitami of Japan up against the Olympic bronze medalist Nehwa of Indonesia. Oh, Indonesia, my goodness, don't get that wrong, Jill. It's India. And of course, she was a former champion here 2 years ago. Their men's doubles and a relatively new partnership of Kai Yun and Lu Kai up against the Asian Games gold medalists Muhammad Hassan and Hendra Setiawan. Then we've got mixed doubles and Jonjit and Thaidaret Thanachai of Thailand up against the Hong Kong pair of Chan and Si. Then women's doubles and the identical twin sisters from China, Liu Ying and Liu Yu. They're up against the home favourites, the number 2 seeds, beaten finalists last year. European champions, of course, Christina Pedersen and Camilla Ruta-Yul. Then the last of our matches today, the 3-time former champion, the 2-time Olympic champion, and now 2-time Asian Games gold medalist Lin Dan. What a welcome return to Denmark for him. He's up against the former champion Jan Jorgensen, number 3 seed this year. Okay, Kim, were you happy with me just leaving it until after the sort of Oldenzaar promo? Yep. Okay, that's good for me. Thank you.
Please welcome the technical officials on court number 3. Thank you.
and a very warm welcome to the ancient city of Odense on the island of Thun for the Yonex Denmark Open, event number 9 on the 12 tournament MetLife BWF World Super Series. Not only is this the 9th event, but we return after a 3-month sabbatical from the Super Series, a period of time which has included the World Championships, the Commonwealth Games, and most recently, the Asian Games. Well, we've got 5 matches for you this afternoon, and we're starting with a women's singles and the World Championship bronze medalist against the Olympic bronze medalist, Mitani of Japan against Nawal of India. Nawal, of course, won this title 2 years ago. Then we've got men's doubles and Kayun and Lu Kai up against the Indonesians, former world champions Muhammad Hassan and Hendra Setian, who have recently returned from Korea with a gold medal from those Asian Games. Then mixed doubles and the Thailand pair of Jongjit and Taratanachai up against Chan and Zi from Hong Kong. Then women's doubles and the identical twin sisters Liu Yu and Liu Ying of China up against the European champions, the number 2 seeds Christina Pedersen and Camilla Orutayul, beaten finalists last year, the Danes. And then the last of our matches this evening is men's singles. Lin Dan, the 3-time former champion, 2-time Olympic champion, and recently winning his 2nd consecutive Asian Games gold medal. He's up against Jan Jorgensen, the 2010 winner here at the Denmark Open. And of course, Jorgensen is the current European champion. So plenty to look forward to this evening as far as play is concerned. I'm Jill Clark, and delighted to say that sitting alongside me is the former world number 1 and 8-time winner of the Denmark Open, Morten Frost. And lovely to see the players back into the Super Series mode. And what an interesting match we've got to start us with today's play.
Yes, it's a very even match. And as you say, very interesting to watch. It's always interesting for me to see Saina Nawal play because, you know, on occasions she's really in form and plays so well, and on other occasions she's a little bit cold and not playing as well as what we expect her to do. So always interesting to see what kind of day it is today.
Yes, well, she's up against a player who's known for her retrieving skills, her fighting spirit, Minatsu Mitani. There she is, the 23-year-old from Japan. She has been as high as 9 in the world ranking, 17 weeks at number 9, but as you can see, a couple of places down from that, currently on the world ranking. Her win-loss record for the year, she's played 9 individual tournaments, and of course the best was here in Denmark at the recent World Championships. She was the number 16 seed, but went home with a bronze medal. Her first match yesterday against Han Lee. That was a difficult opening match, I have to say, on paper. That was one that I was particularly interested to watch. But as you can see, she came through relatively comfortably. 21-17, 21-17 in 40 minutes. So to Saina Nawal, well, she's 24 years of age, number 7 on the world ranking at the moment. Now, she won this Denmark Open title 2 years ago when she was the number 3 seed, beat Juliana Schenk in that final, making her 6th appearance here at the Denmark Open. Last year, she didn't live up to expectations. She was the number 4 seed, lost in the quarterfinal stage. And my goodness, she did have to struggle yesterday. I watched that one. She lost the opening game 12-21 against Karin Schnarzer of Germany, but comfortable in the end. So Saina Nawal, who of course won the Olympic bronze medal in London in 2012. And this will be the 7th meeting between these two players. Last time they met was in the Uber Cup earlier this year in Delhi. 2 straight games to Saina Nawal. Of course, she has the advantage, having won 4 of the previous 6 encounters. Jakob Sindberg of Denmark is our umpire. Henrik Boas, also of Denmark, the service judge. Well, Saina Nawal winner of the last Super Series event prior to this one. Eighth Super Series event of the year, the first ever Australian Super Series events.
Yeah, that was very important for Simon Nable to win that one, to get her back on track. And as you can see, she's also getting up in the ranking back to seven. She has been slipping quite dramatically in the ranking lately.
So Simon Nable, the former champion, nearest to us, getting the second round match underway. Very interesting, Horton, you talk about her ranking slipping. I mean, she has been as high as world number two. And it was interesting in January last year, she said, now that I'm back to world number two, I will definitely become world number one, which I thought was a bold statement to say the least. And she's struggled since then. But after the World Championships here in Copenhagen.
Yeah, that's the interesting part.
Yes, she's changed coaches. She has left Pulola Gopichand and she's moved to the guidance of Vimal Kumar.
Yep, in Bangalore.
In Bangalore.
Yes.
Now, I don't know what your thoughts on that are, whether that's a good thing. Is that a knee-jerk reaction? Because, of course, the other Indian player, PV Sindhu, is doing well. She won her second consecutive bronze medal at World Championships. A bit of rivalry.
Oh, a huge rivalry between the two players, and I'm sure that Simon Nable possibly felt that some attention was taken away from her by PV Sindhu, and then she opted to go to Bangalore and play under Prakash Padukone and Vimal Kumar, my two good old friends in Bangalore. But I'm not sure whether that is permanent or not. It's more like testing, I think.
Yeah. Going wide. It's interesting you mention your friend Prakash Padukone. He's the only other Indian player to win a title here at the Denmark Open. Mm. 1979.
Yeah.
You've got a puzzled expression on your face. Have I got my research wrong?
I think so. I think so, yes. I have a very puzzled. Because I think that I lost to him in 1980 in the final.
Ah, I'll come to that in a minute because this is the most phenomenal rally. Great rally, and that's indicative, I think, of the sort of rallies we're going to see time and time again. Simon Nable taking the initiative and Mitani doing all the scrambling back. Now, just to return to your point, when I was researching this, in the list of former champions, it says the year 79-80, 80-81, 81-82. And I've taken the first calendar year.
I beat Rudy Hartono in the semi-final of that year and played Prakash in the final, and he won it. And then later he went on to win the All England.
Okay. Well, there's confusion because they haven't got a set year for those championships.
Okay. Makes sense. Anyway, just old history.
Yeah.
Old fogies like us. But you're right, when, you know, your analysis of this match, I totally concur with you that we will see Simon Nable trying to be the controlling player, the one who wants to attack, the one who wants to dictate the pace and everything. And Mitani is just retrieving whatever she can. And it's basically, can Simon Nable keep up the pace and the power and the pressure? She would win comfortably, can she not? And get sucked in by what Mitani is getting back, then it can be a really big struggle.
Yeah. Little sign of frustration there from Mitani. Now I notice she's got that right knee really very heavily strapped, the Japanese player.
Yeah, not only knee, it's a thigh and all the way up.
Yeah. Now, perhaps that's an explanation, Morten, for the fact that at the Asian Games in Incheon in Korea, she was playing first women's singles in the team competition where Japan won a bronze medal, but she didn't or wasn't selected for the women's singles individual event.
Yeah, that could play, I don't know, but that could play a role. She might have been injured after the first event.
The team event, yes. Yeah. That's a delightful drop shot. So typical of Sayan and Ewell. Delightful racket head control.
Yeah, and I also think that you should not read too much into the first round. I know that Naval was struggling against Schnarse from Germany. But, you know, playing first round is always not easy. It's never, never, never easy. So, you know, before you settle in, before you get onto court, before you get into the tournament, things can happen. And very often when we see upsets happening in a tournament, it's always the first round.
Mm.
Not always, often.
Service over. 8-4.
Of course, Sayan and Ewell missed the Commonwealth Games, couldn't defend her Commonwealth Games title that she had so dramatically won 4 years earlier in Delhi because of injury problems. Missed it.
9-4.
I think that was good play by Sayan and Ewell. That clear, that attacking clear down the line there was a good play because so often she opt for that downwards shot, either the drop shot, the half smash or the full smash. But this time she opted for the more attacking clear and then making use of the full court, which I think was a good move. And that forced an error from Mitani.
Down as an unforced error in my book because the clear was woefully short.
And in badminton terms, it is way out.
Yeah. Of course, we have got the challenge system in operation here. And Hawkeye will be called to adjudicate if a player challenges a line judge's decision. Been a couple of errors on the forehand defence from Sayan and Ewell. I wonder if that's a particular tactic of Mitani.
I think that's too early to say.
Yeah. It's gone wide. So a three-point advantage for the former champion, Sayan and Ewell.
ठीक है फंस रही तो ऑल द टाइम स्मैश नहीं मार रही अराउंड हेड में भी वो थोड़ा रेडी रहे स्लाइस मार रही है तभी वो क्या हो रहा है थोड़ा आगे आ रहा है ना मुश्किल आ रहा है और नेट से भी ना ऐसे दिखा के पीछे झटका यू रख पुश कर पीछे पीछे छोड़ दिया आउटराइट मारने की स्मैश मारने की मत जा ठीक है
नो मैं रूमिता विश
लाइट
एक्शन टॉस है ऐसे मार के साइना वो जैसे स्लाइस मार रही है ना वो भी उधर से ये ड्रॉप फिर घुमा के फोर हैंड से वो फंस रही है उसमें ठीक है ना
Well, something about the round the head smash, and maybe take a bit of pace off. Slicing.
I don't really read it well.
Seven,
I think.
Eight.
That's well.
Yeah, it's magnificent.
Yeah, good play. Very nice lift.
12, 8.
Yeah, you can really see the strapping on the right leg there of Mitani.
She's got a very, very nice net play on that backhand side to Saina Neville. Seen that on many, many occasions, and that's one of her very strong points in her game. I really admire that really good touch she's got there. Once again, it's just clipping the top of the tape.
Opened up a 5-point cushion now. Oh, that's nice. Oh, so
well covered. Yeah.
So much for my theory about the weakness on the forehand defence. That's put me in my place.
But I think what you noticed was that when she's playing a slice cross court, Mitani is playing slice cross court from the forehand side to the forehand side.
Yeah.
That's where she missed it twice, so that's a different shot. Saved you on that one. But a very commanding lead here for Saina Neville. Very comfortable.
That's nice.
16.
And of course, if you have got a problem with your lunge leg, right leg for a right-hander.
That's the trouble spot more than any.
Exactly.
Yes. It's trouble enough without injuries, I'm telling you.
Me.
What a miss.
Well, after the push deep into the 16. Japanese player's forehand
this
corner.
This is perfect.
Yes, and look at her movement. She's singing it's coming.
Yeah. She's overhitting it. She's doing too much on it, and then obviously she's missing it. But a nice little drop shot would have done really good. Would have been enough.
Yeah, well, that run of points comes from the end. 6 straight points it was. Just wide. Yeah, and look at the body language of Mitani after that.
17,
you could see, oh dear.
9.
Yeah. Not happy with herself at all.
that's good play.
Nice to see the net exchanges, though.
Yes.
See it in men's singles all the time, don't we? It's becoming more and more of a feature in women's singles.
It is. It's definitely a feature that the women's singles players have to focus on.
Ooh, ooh, there's going to be a challenge here. Yep, here we go. Challenge from Mitani. It was called out. And my instinctive reaction, Morton, but you know what I'm like at getting these wrong or right, was that it landed in.
I think it's in too. I couldn't see it on the baseline first time around, but when I was watching it here on the screen, it looks in. But let's see.
Well, Hawkeye will make the decision. Great innovation for the sport. It's usually put up on the giant screen. Indeed it is, and it's here for us, and that's Wellen.
Yeah,
good challenge.
So too remains.
Two challenges per match, of course. And providing you get your challenge right, you keep that challenge. So it's very similar to tennis.
You can have as many as you like.
Just keep getting it right.
Yes.
Yeah, that's delightful.
12-17.
But I think tactically there is a conscious decision from Mitani to try to attack Nabel's forehand sides, whether it's at the net, smashes down the line, the cross-court smash, pressure on the deep forehand corner and all that. I think there is a conscious decision there.
Good rally, though.
19-12.
Of course, Mitani in those recent World Championships, what a run she had. All the way through to the semi-final. First Japanese medalist in the women's singles for 37 years, since the very first World Championships, when the late Hiro Yuki won a bronze medal in Malmo. So a great achievement for Mitani, but just hasn't got the same pace. I haven't seen the same pace in her movement here. I know we've only had a couple of days of the tournament, Morton, but seems a pace down to her performance at the World Championships. That is very, very good judgment from Saina Newell. So game points. As long as well, so the first time of asking.
No point in challenging that one anyway. It was a very tight, very close call here. Look at that. It's very, very close.
Yeah, but that is out. That's great line call. So 19 minutes for the opening game. And the former champion won game to the group. 21-12.
थोड़ा बहुत कभी हाफ स्मैश भी मार सकती है है ना चाहे हाफ स्मैश मार और ऐसे दिखा के कई बार ही ना जब वो नेट पे है ना तब उसको पुश मारो छोटी है ना फंसती है फिर देन वेट फॉर द स्लाइस वो तेरे फोरहैंड में ज़्यादा स्लाइसेस मारे हाँ ठीक है वो ध्यान रखो हाँ बस यो यो बस
हाँ ना
देख तूने वो जब पुश करा फंस गई तूने दाश कोई इतना नहीं जा रेडी रहे ताकि इसको चिपका दे कई बार जैसे नेट पे ड्रिबल कर वेरिएशंस कर ऐसे चिपका दिया फिर यूं रोक के हाथ रोक के पुश बिल्कुल परफेक्ट ऐसे अननेसेसरी मारने में जब मिले तब मार और ऐसे ही स्लाइस फोर हैंड से क्रॉस मिले ना जब वहाँ पे फंस गई है ना देखा चूधर फोर हैंड में वो पहुँच नहीं पा रही चल कम ऑन दैट्स इट
कोच मधुमिता always very, very animated in the way she talks to her players. She's a wonderful person, isn't she, Morten?
Yeah, she's into it.
Yeah. No, Shodi's Sato of Japan.
Yeah, former very, very good men's singles player.
One, yes, and in fact, was at the London Olympics in men's doubles.
Yeah, he was converted into doubles player.
Yeah,
later
so
on,
fast, wasn't
he,
it?
He was some of the quickest we've ever seen.
So the number seven seed, Saina Nehwal from India, one game to the good, 21-12 that opening game against Minetsu Mitani of Japan.
Mitani was very, very lucky here. Look at that shot. Almost going over from Saina Nehwal here. And that is a very difficult shot to play, that tumble net shot from the forehand side.
Idea from Mitani, but she just puts herself under so much pressure.
Yeah, she can't control that one.
No, and she I know she's very good at retrieving, Morten, but as the rallies are in progress, I keep thinking to myself, you know, at some stage, you've got to take some initiative, surely.
Three, I agree. Either you take initiative and attack before the opponent attack. That's the simplicity of it. Or if she wants to play her very best style, as is the retrieving style, the quality of her shot has to be better. You know, if I always say the secret behind a good defense is a good lift. If the lift is short, no matter who you are and how good you are under pressure.
Yeah.
So you've got to play a good lift. She's got to play good clears, good lifts, good net shots. Good half smashes, that's what she was doing here. This is going out. She's got to play good quality shots to be able to start retrieving. And that's what I think is letting her down at the moment. The quality in the basic game is not good enough at the moment. This is good. This is good. That's good length. That's what I'm asking.
Good use of the body smash from Saina Nehwal. Two titles this year for Saina Nehwal, not only the Australian Super Series, but also the Said Modi India Grand Prix Gold event, and that was her first title for 15 months since winning this Denmark Open of 2012. The concerning things, Morten, for Saina Nehwal fans is that apart from those two titles, the best after that is not, well, she hasn't gone beyond a quarter final.
Yeah, for a long time.
Yeah.
For a long, long time. She was really into a long spell of not so good results.
Yeah. You read the same newspapers as me.
I do.
Morden, in India. And rather controversial comment from Saina Nawal about how she felt the BWF should restrict the number of players from one particular nation that happens to do particularly well in world badminton in order to give everybody else a chance.
Yeah, and I totally disagree.
Exactly.
I must say. I can't find polite ways of saying it.
Well, I can understand for events like the Olympic Games that you restrict the number of competitors per country. It's in the Olympic Charter that you can't have more than three in any sport, in any discipline, across the board, Winter and Summer Olympics.
Yes.
I understand that. I understand it for World Championships, but in open badminton.
It's open. That's the word.
That's the whole point of it.
Yes.
And this is why premier events like this Super Series event here in Denmark is so special, because you have all the best players. And if they, a number of them happen to come from one nation, so be it.
So be it. Totally agree.
5-7.
Worried expression. Missed it.
Yeah.
But there's that one that I'd noticed earlier.
Yeah. That's a winner. Mm. It's definite winner here. Yeah, obviously, it was out by an inch or so, but Nawal, she was way away from that one. Nowhere near. Counter-attacking there. Good shot. Good follow-up.
Goodness me. Yeah, no wonder she's disappointed with that.
She worked that rally so well. Putting a lot of pressure on that backhand side on more than one occasion. Played it really well, good follow-up, and what a miss.
No, this is a handsome lead now, one game up. Yeah. And 6 points up here in the second for the former champion, Saina Nawal.
और फोरहैंड में बराबर तूने उसको पुशेस भी कर रही है फंसा रही है बिल्कुल उसका ऑप्शन इधर स्मैश है अगर स्मैश में तेरे को अगर मिलता ना मार रही है अगर घुमा फर्स्ट गेम में घुमाया क्रॉस घुमा सकते ना दोनों साइड से बहुत अच्छा है ठीक है ना
Interesting there, Morten, the fact that it's not often we see Saina Nawal joining in with the coaching discussion. And that's good to see. I like to see a player join in rather than just being told to be involved in the the process of deciding tactics?
Totally agree. And in my opinion, that's my personal opinion, I think that it shows commitment, passion, interest. You know, you're into your game, and if there is something coaches are saying that you do not either agree with or do agree with, you know, you should either say, okay, I agree, this is the way we're going to go, or no, I do not agree, because I don't feel comfortable doing that. If you just have this walk of talk, you know, you just have a wall that's coming to you all the time, and you just take it in and say, oh, yeah, they can say whatever they want. Obviously, it would always be good to have a dialogue more than anything.
The English expression here, Morten, just to explain
thank
concisely
you.
Exactly what you were saying, because there's an expression that's something like, tell me I forget, ask me I remember, involve me I know.
So that's very poetic.
Yes. Yeah. Involve me in the process, I know what's happening, I understand what's happening.
Yeah.
Yeah,
definitely. That's where my English is coming short.
Not at all.
Yeah, but that was very nicely said.
It's called out.
It is out.
Yeah. 13. Well, this challenge has to be immediate, and I would guess that was not immediate. Oof, good call, line judge. Yeah. My goodness me.
It's going to be one-way traffic now.
Yeah. I said a little earlier, Morten, that I thought Mitani was not as quick as we saw her at the World Championships. You know, not that last rally, which was relatively short, but the previous rally to that. I did wonder, actually, if that Mitani could really extend some more rallies. I thought there were signs that perhaps Saina Nawal was not as quick as we've seen her, for instance, when she won the Olympic bronze medal.
Yeah, but then Mitani really have to keep the pressure up here. And the last two or three rallies after the long one, she hasn't done it.
No.
So she had to do it on a very, very consistent basis if she's going to win that way. And it doesn't look like she's capable of doing that today, because these mistakes are creeping into her game. So I agree with you, but then it have to be rally after rally after rally and really wear her down. You know, one rally now and again is not really doing it.
Well, she had got Saina Nawal out of position, but couldn't capitalize.
Yeah. But that follow-up is too late. She could have got it even earlier. There was only one reply to that smash, and that was that short straight block. She could have followed up so much quicker.
My serve is long.
And once again, Mitani was not able to keep that straight smash down the line in. And from now, I think the scoreline will only be cosmetic. From watching the match here, I don't think you can say that Mitani is injured, because I don't think she is. But I think due to injury, possibly, she's not as well prepared for this one as what she's been for other tournaments.
Yeah.
20, match point, 9.
So match points are plenty for the former champion, Simon Ewell. Second time of asking, and Simon Ewell, the number 7 seed, is safely through to the quarter final here at the Yonex Denmark Open. 2 straight games over Minatsu Mitani of Japan. Umpire just confirming the score, 21-12, 21-10 in 37 minutes of play. Well, all credit to Simon Ewell, who took the game to her opponent. She's always been a worker on court, has Ewell. In 37 minutes to secure her quarterfinal berth, where she will meet the number 2 seed, Wang Chexian of China. There, confirmation of that scoreline. 2 straight games, comfortable for the number 7 seed. So, of course, the end of season Super Series finals, the destination Dubai this year and for 4 years. And looking at the women's singles list at the moment, well, you can see there's three Chinese players on the top there. Four Chinese players in total. Well, the number two and three swapped places after the Australian Open, because Wang Shuxian, who's the number two seed here in Denmark, reached the semi-final in Sydney. The other two Chinese players at one and three didn't play the Australian Super Series. Sina Nehwal, of course, won in Sydney, and she went up one place to number nine. Two Koreans, two Thailand players, and four Chinese.
Court number one, men's doubles. Please welcome from China.
After our women's singles, next up is men's doubles, then mixed doubles, women's doubles, and men's singles. And of course, home involvement in the fourth and fifth match this evening. So to the men's doubles pair, a relatively new pair of...